ready to match the star. Scoey Mitchell, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joan Collins, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Reilly.
Johnny Olson.
And friends.
Doesn't she look out of it like something out of The Great Gatsby?
The Great Gatsby?
Yeah, that was, oh, they had a lot of chicly dressed.
And like she looks as old as Zelda Fitzgerald.
I didn't mean it, Joan. I was only kidding.
It's a little touch. And she's just funning you a little bit. You look very chic. And
so do you.
Thank
so
you.
So do you. Yes. I love your tie.
Thank you. We make a lovely couple, don't we, then?
Make
bored.
Me a couple and I'll tell you. Biggie, the best thing I ever heard.
All right, what do you say? We say hello to the two players here, Doug Brady and Lynn Taylor. Okay. Doug is the current champ. If you were with us last time, remember he won a total of $600, and he just missed winning the $5,000 by hair's breadth. Yes, one letter of the alphabet, as a matter of fact. Now, we started this game. We're in the middle of round two, and it's 2-1 at this moment. When we come back and give you your question, you must match one celebrity to achieve a tie. Two, however, will win the game for you, Doug, and we'll see how that turns out right after we see about this. Okay, we are ready to carry on. Are you ready to carry on?
Yes, I am.
All right, Doug, this is all yours. Listen carefully. Count Dracula's head.
I wish I had a quart of blood.
No. The Transylvania Blood Bank just foreclosed on my loan. By dark of night, they came and repossessed my blank. Transylvania Blood Bank just foreclosed on my loan. By dark of night, they came and repossessed my blank. Everybody ready up here? No. Not quite.
I was trying to remember what the word was.
You're the only one who doesn't play.
That's right. Old Bright Eyes over
the first
here.
One. Right. Okay, Scoey's ready. Joan, Richard are ready. Waiting for Brett and Charles.
They're not worth waiting for.
All right, come on now. Put that thing in. All right, we come over here to Doug Brady.
That's not what my new beau says.
Count Dracula said, the Transylvania Blood Bank just foreclosed on my loan. By dark of night, they came and repossessed my blank.
Vampire teeth.
My teeth.
That's not bad.
Wait a minute. Let me write that down.
Yeah, write that down. All right, he had big, fangy-type teeth, Scoey.
Have you enjoyed yourself, Doug?
Yes.
End of the line is what he's telling you, Doug, but don't listen to him. You never know about what can happen up here.
I'm surprised because anyone who is familiar with Count Dracula and so forth knows that he drinks his blood through straws.
He does.
Same audience, huh?
They love you.
You enjoyed yourself, Skelton? What's wrong with him?
I'd go with Doug, huh?
The two of them are leaving together. What'd you say, Brett?
Well, it took me a little time to think of what it was I wanted. But as it turned out, it wasn't worth the effort because I said syringe.
Syringe?
No, don't boo me.
What are you thinking about?
Now, wait, we'll find. When they start applauding, you know we've come to a good answer. Charles?
Don't count on it. I said his bats.
Bravado! And he's not even right. Italian.
Yes. Are they going to boo your answer, Joan?
Oh, I know they're going to boo. All Doug, right. I'm
but
sorry.
Wait, hold everything. Boo now for her. Boo. Okay, cut. Now, Sean, don't boo when she shows it there.
What's Monster. That?
Monster.
Deserve two boos.
Yes. All right, what do you say, Richard? You got to match Richard, Doug, to stay in the game, and he's looking for vampire teeth. They came and repossessed my teeth.
Repossessed your house. So where did he live?
He lived in a coffin.
You bet your life.
Oh, that's right. Hey. Here you go. Stand by for a moment. Well, we're going to talk to Doug Brady. Doug, you won just enough to get back to Daytona Beach, didn't you?
It was well worth it. I enjoyed it very much. Really.
Now, did you bring the group with you? Any of the family?
No, just myself.
You just came alone, eh?
All right. Came alone.
They'll welcome you back with open arms because you're a peachy kid and a nifty dancer, and we say goodbye to Doug Brady. Hello there. You ready?
I guess I'm good.
Now, Lynn Taylor's going to have a go at over $5,000 here. Let's see how she does. She said she's ready, so we'll go right ahead with it. You've got your 100. Let's see how much more you're going to win. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Buy blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. $250 if you hook up with that one. $100 for the bottom one. Whom do you call on?
Brett.
Bicentennial.
Bicentennial.
Me like that.
That's, there's one.
Charles.
Bisexual.
Hurry them all, Gore.
We've got to go on now. Control yourself.
Okay. Richard.
I don't believe in buying it. Anyway, what did you say, darling? Bifocals.
Bifocals?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, sure, you're cheer sexual, and someone with bad eyesight gets a boob, right?
Bunch of freaks here. What, Charles?
I was going to say bi plane, but my answer's more fun.
Yes. Okay, so you got bifocal, bisexual, and bicentennial. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better one in your head? After all, you're a school teacher. You're a very smart lady. You can figure this out. What do you think that audience did?
Oh, this is so hard. I'll go with bisexual.
Really? Okay. Follow me. All right, bisexual is the one she wants.
By George.
Whatever turns you on, what do I care? All right, bisexual, let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Bilingual.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Okay.
That's We're a looking... popular favorite.
Yes, indeed, it is. We are looking for the answer, bisexual. May we see the $250 response? It is there! Congratulations. Did you honestly think it was going to be there? Did you really think it was going to be there?
Yeah. No.
What do you think is under the big one?
Centennial.
All right, here it is. Earl, slide it. Centennial. Why did you say that? You couldn't decide.
No.
Okay. Well, listen. You're up to $350 now.
Get the money, Mama.
That's right.
I think you should get. You should get twice the money for bisexual.
I would think so. Yes.
Don't so ask me.
I'd like to chip in a couple of dollars.
Ten times 250 means you play for $2,500. Which celebrity do you think you can match for to collect that amount?
Richard.
All right, Richard.
Gave you bifocals, of course.
Now you turn around this way, and I'll get with a question here and ask Richard if he's ready.
Yep.
Blank rat. R-A-T. Blank rat. All right, he's finished. Now we need an answer from you which you think will match his. What do you say to that? Blank rat.
I can only think of pack rat.
Pack rat. Pack rat. Oh yeah, that was a popular phrase not too long ago. We'll find out right now for $2,500 if it matches Richard.
I never even thought of that. I thought of you, dirty rat.
Yeah.
And a picture that I did called King Rat. Yeah.
King
that was
Rat.
The only thing that I could think of. Yeah.
You never thought of King
the
Rat?
The reviews, by the way, were exactly the same for the film.
Yes.
As you gave me for this card.
You dirty rat, did you think of that?
Now that he said that, yes.
It stimulated your memory. Now, Lynn, you got your $350, and a little bit later on, you'll meet another player and play another game. But right now, we're going to do a little business with America, okay?
Okay, fine.
Now I'm ready. Are you ready? Hello there. Let's welcome Vicki Gerald. How are you, Vicki?
Hi.
Now, would you please tell us a little bit about yourself, Vicki?
Sure. I'm from Washington, D.C.
Yes.
And I came out here this summer with some friends for vacation. And we've decided to extend it and stay for good because we like it so much.
Well, that's marvelous. Well, I hope we can contribute to your stay here. We wish you the best of luck. Let's begin, shall we? Ask you to make a selection.
A, please.
A, here we go. For Vicki, I have a TV guide listing for you now.
Oh,
listen carefully. It says, Sunday night, CBS Kojak. And the synopsis, the plot goes, Kojak is kidnapped by a weird artist who paints Kojak's head to look like a blank. Yes?
Was that a male artist or a female artist?
It just says a weird artist. I don't think the gender has anything to do with the answer.
I'd like to know gender, because according to gender, it would be according to what that person... Was it a male artist? It would be a certain kind
All
of...
we have is the adjective weird. Weirdo.
Weird or heads to look like a... Okay.
You know who Kojak is?
No.
He's a bald-headed actor.
He is?
Yes, from 2nd Avenue in New York City and 71st Street.
I thought he was Hubert Humphrey's cousin.
Write an answer already. Ah, that's good. Just put it right in the slot there. That's it. Your manual dexterity is remarkable.
My manual? My e-manual?
Yes.
What did you say?
Leave her alone at the Castagas. Leave her.
I finished.
She came with me and she's leaving with me.
Oh,
all right.
Pick up picks. That's what that says. I have to remember to do that tomorrow.
Vicki Gerald, a TV guide listing, Sunday night, CBS Kojak. Kojak is kidnapped by a weird artist who paints Kojak's head to look like a...
A woman. I can't think of anything.
You can't think of anything? Okay. Her answer is a woman. Not your all-time thrilling answer, but what the heck?
You know, the audience was so disappointed they didn't even boo.
Yeah, that's right. What the heck's happening? You forgot to boo. Let's hear it for her. Okay, cut. That's enough.
That's your partiality.
Yeah. All right, now we get ready for him, too, because...
No, I think Brett brought up a very good point, whether it was male or female. I'd like to take it one step further. Were they black or white? Yeah, no, because I imagine from my background, the only thing I could think of was they painted to look like a watermelon.
A watermelon, yeah.
Well, I think I'm in love.
All
Let's
right.
get rid of Claire and go off to the... Tahitian. Well, you see, I was joshing you before. I know who he was all the time.
Oh, you did?
I said basketball.
Basketball is a very good answer. Charles?
But with the holes in the ears, it was a bowling ball.
A bowling ball. That's another good one. All right. Vicki is looking for the answer. Woman. Painted Kojak's head to look like a woman.
Well, I have to go along with everybody who's talking about different kinds of balls, and I have down a beach ball.
Beach ball. Yes, that's good. That would be interesting. Gaily colored with stripes and all that sort of swirls
Red
and everything.
Festive, festive, festive. And
beautiful, yes.
Whatsoever.
All right.
Gaily covered with stripes and swirls?
Yeah. That's what a beach ball is.
Could you do my dressing room for me? Drab up there.
Just painted all
I
different.
Thought... What was the question?
Painted... weird artist painted Kojak's head to look like a...
A toupee.
A toupee. Oh, wouldn't that be
interesting?
Isn't
that a pretty picture?
Yeah, that's a beautiful picture.
This is from the people who brought you King Rat.
Yes. Now... That's called lukewarm applause. Now listen, either
well,
do it...
it's better than the shock we had when...
That's right. Either do it or don't do it. Now, don't be indecisive.
Yes, please.
Okay, that's enough. You really haven't got your heart in it. We're going to have to get rid of you.
Yes.
You clear the studio,
like
John. Oh, baby, wait a minute. Before you go, listen to Patty's answer.
It's not necessary.
Yeah.
Strike.
Strike a bowling ball. Okay, so... I'm sorry, that's nothing for you, Vicki, and your question will come along later, but right now we've got this especially for you, so pay attention. Here we go. Second half of round one. Ready, Lynn Taylor, this is all yours. When Otto...
Who?
Otto. We've never had this fella on the show before. Oh. Otto. When Otto tried to be the life of the party by putting a lampshade on his head, Sally went over and blanked him. Remember Otto? He was at all those... All those Condé Nast parties. Otto, you remember Otto?
Yes, Otto the Otto.
He used to attend every party. He was a member of the Algonquin Round Table, and he was a very charming fellow, witty fellow, storyteller. Put a lampshade on his head, Sally went over and blanked him.
Of course she did.
All right. You can throw that one away. That's it. Ready up there.
Is there an obvious answer to this one?
When Otto tried to be the life of the party, well, the first round questions are, you know, can be...
A little out of
you
filter.
You can run a field there. I'm sorry there.
Sally went over and...
What? Cut it out, you two.
Oh, thank you.
We're just sitting here
talking.
We weren't
doing anything, officer.
Yeah, nothing. We're all in the back seat.
What are you doing down there?
I don't know. Come on now. You got to do something here.
Okay.
Okay. Everybody's ready. The redhead is going to put in a slot in a moment now. Lynn Taylor, it's up to you. When Otto tried to be the life of the party by putting a lampshade on his head, Sally went over and blanked him.
Lit him?
Lit him is a good answer, yes. The past tense. Sally went over and lit him because he had a lampshade on his head, you know.
Well, in order to lit him,
yes,
you must plug him.
Plug him. Oh, she plugged him in. Right. Okay. I don't know. Well, blanked, you see, lit is the past tense of light. And she
How does one do that?
Well, you see, when the lampshade's on the head, all right, you just turn the switch. Look at that. See the way his eyes lit up?
Don't stop now. You made an old performer very happy.
I'll show you what kind of show this is.
Oh, it's one of those.
Yes. All right, Brett, you're up.
Well, you know, I was thrilled with my answer, and I turned to Charles, and I said, and yours is already in the slot, so don't try and steal it, right? We have the same answer, and it matches hers. Turned him on.
Turned him on.
Hello, player. Okay.
Charles.
Couldn't you just turn it over without that long story?
Turned him on. Okay, two for Lynn. Joan Collins, what do you say?
I just say that she punched him, that's all.
She punched him, clubbed him. That's good.
I knew it. Yes. I was waiting for that.
That's enough. Don't make her feel insecure. What do you say?
Do. She's already a nervous wreck.
No, cool. Not too much.
No, good.
Plugged him in.
Plugged him in.
That's all I could think of.
That's all you can think of. All right, and you, my dear.
A reprise of Plugged Him In.
A reprise of Plugged Him In. Okay.
Thank you.
So that's two for you. Now we go to round two and see what happens here. Vicky?
Take B this time.
Okay. B, here we go. Didn't match anybody last time, everybody blazed. Don Rickles said, I'll never insult a plumber. The last time I tried it, the plumber rammed his blank down my throat.
I'm sorry you went so fast.
Well, Don Rickles talks fast. He's right.
I know.
I'll never insult a plumber. The last time I tried it, the plumber rammed his blank down my throat. Quickly now, the plumber.
Well, I am. I'm going Don as quickly Rickles. As Don Rickles. I love Don Rickles.
Do not...
Do that.
Ready? Everybody ready? All right, Vicky Gerald. Don Rickles said, I'll never insult a plumber again. The last time I tried it, the plumber rammed his blank down my throat.
What are these? Plungers?
The plunger. Okay, she says plunger. The audience seems to like her response of plunger. What do you say?
I can take another boo. I said, be an old alumni from Manual High. Snake.
Snake. Well, that's the thing that cleans out the pipes. Right. Yes, of course. Brett, what do you say?
Well, we have to hurry along here, right? It's the speed of the plunger.
Plunger. Plunger, Vicky. Charles.
A plongeur.
Plongeur. And Joan.
His tools.
Shoved his tools. Okay, Richard.
Plungero.
Plungero. That's three for you and Patty.
Another name for a plunger is the plumber's friend.
Friend, that's right. That's a plunger, right. Well, look at that. Middle of round two, score is 4-2, and we got to stop right now, ladies, so hold your breath. In the meantime, we got this message. Now, how did you feel about it? This is the end of your first week out here with us.
Probably my last. I find
it
got better and better.
Yes.
I feel very good now. I didn't get hissed too much in the last
show. Right. Give her a round warm of applause to make her feel better. Thank you very much. Okay. Now, the next time we get together, these are the people you'll see on this stage.
Robert Urich. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Jamie Lynn Bauer. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Fly.
Thank you all. You were splendid. Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.